Last week, I released a couple free customizable green screen camera overlays, and honestly, I'm pretty happy with how they came out with the clean colored backgrounds. But this week, I wanted to expand on that, because another cool effect you can do with a green screen is making it look like you're sort of popping out of your original regular camera background, which is pretty easy to do in OBS alone by just taking your camera background and putting yourself over it, but you still probably want a cool camera border, a place to put some metrics, and some easier controls to customize it just the way you want. So that is where I come in. I went ahead and made a new version of the green screen camera overlay template I released last week, designed specifically for this effect. All you have to do is take a picture of your room from the angle of your webcam, or any room, download the file from the Discord, link in the description, and follow along. And I'd also recommend watching the video from last week. It goes over the controls in more depth for changing the color and the shape of these overlays. And before we get started, if you enjoy the free graphics, please do consider hitting that like and subscribe button. It's completely free, it lets you know when there's new stuff, and it really helps me out. That being said, let's get started. My name is Chris Folea. I'm your stream scholar. Welcome to Stream School. All right, when you first open the Blender file, it should look very similar to this. And if you watched last week's video, which I would highly recommend if you want an in-depth look at the controls for these overlays, then all of this should look pretty familiar in general. But the very first thing you want to do is come up here and click the shiny circle button. That'll put this viewport into rendered preview mode so you can see your overlay as you're working on it. Then you'll notice the main difference from last week is that instead of a gradient ramp colored background, we now have an actual background image, which we'll get to how to manipulate and change that in just a second. But first, let's do a quick refresher on the controls for these overlays. So for overlay one, we have the big arrow right here, which changes the height of the overlay. Then we have the small arrows, which change the shape of the overlay. We have three different points, and you can move these or rotate them if you really want to. Then we have the quad arrow, which moves the gradient around, scales it, or rotates it. And then if you hit space, you can see that the gradient still animates sweeping through the overlay. Then over here, we have our different color options. So gradient one changes on the material panel, changes the color for the first point of the gradient. Then gradient two changes the color for the second point of the gradient. And the border color changes the border color, which is pretty self-explanatory. Then up in the collection, you can also turn off the metrics or the logo if you just want the border with the image backdrop. And you can also change the logo by clicking on it and replacing it with your logo by coming down to the materials panel, hitting the X where it says your L, hitting open, and finding your logo. I'm personally going to use my fish logo that I use on my own personal stream. Then for overlay two, we have this arrow control, which changes the height of the overlay. Then we have these two arrow controls, which change the height and position of this LED bar. Then over here, we have all the different color controls. So you can change the LED color, you can change the plastic color, you can change the metal color. You have a lot of control here. You can change the color of just about anything. And the background color isn't visible right now because the image is covering it up. But then under overlay two, you can also get rid of the metrics and the logo. And that pretty much sums up the quick refresher. So let's get to how to manipulate the backdrop. So if we come up to overlay one and we look at this background image and we have background turned on, which you can turn this off and on, by the way, but with the background on, you'll notice we have two new controls. We have background image and we have this little square with the triangles. So let's start by swapping this out for your background image, because as much as I love the Stream School background image, I don't think all of you want that for your stream. So if you select the background image text, you can come over here to the materials panel, hit the X where it says back, then hit open and replace that with your own background image. So I personally really like the StreamSchool image here, but just know that you can get creative with this. The first obvious option would be to take out your phone and from the angle of your camera, take a picture of your room. But if you don't like that, you could go take a picture of a different room or somewhere outdoors in the middle of the woods. Or you can get creative. What if you want to stream from, I don't know, let's say you want to stream from your spice cabinet in your kitchen. You want to be extra spicy. That's an option too. So this image can be anything you want as long as it's a 16:9 aspect ratio, which is 1920 by 1080 or 1280 by 720. It's like the default dimensions for a video file these days. But you can put any image back there that you want. My personal recommendation would be using your room or finding another room in your house, but taking a picture from the same angle and height as your webcam or camera that you're using. So I'm personally gonna stick to the StreamSchool backdrop, and let's move on to the next control. So this box right here with the arrow sticking out of it allows you to change the position and the scale of your background image. So if we come up here and select the movement widget, and we click the white circle on the movement widget and we can drag this around. We can move it wherever we want, but you'll notice we don't have a ton of leeway there. And that's because this is scaled down pretty much to match as is. So to fix that, we can come down to the scale widget and we can scale that up or down, which is kind of like either, it's kind of like changing the field of view of your camera or the focal length. So you can have like a really zoomed in camera, or you can have like a really wide field of view. This is completely up to you. If you zoom it in, then you can move it around some and you can sort of put this background wherever you want. Then one final option you have here is to rotate it, which I don't know why you would ever want to do that, but you can. So we could rotate this at a really weird angle. We could scale it up. And that doesn't look believable even in the slightest, but the option is available to you. So once you get your background image set and you have it set in a position and scale that you like, and you have the overlay manipulated how you like it, then you're probably going to want to export this. And that is also identical to last week. But last week I didn't mention one important thing, and that is adjusting the render camera size. So if we select the camera and go to the little camera button right here, sorry, the printer button, I always get that mixed up. Go to the Y resolution, we can shrink that to better match the scale of our overlay. Then we can grab the movement widget and we can move the camera down till this is centered. So having some transparent pixels on the edge is totally fine. You just want to get this close. And if you want to spend the time to get this absolutely perfect, that's cool too, more power to you. But once this is lined up, all you have to do for a still image is hit F12 on your keyboard or go to render, render image. It'll render the image out. You go to image, save as, and save it wherever you want. Or if you want to render the animation, you can go to the little printer icon and under output, I have all of the correct codec and video options selected for you to export a WebM file with transparency. So all you have to do is find a location for your output by clicking the folder icon. I'm personally gonna put mine in the same location. So this is gonna be overlay, heck yes, hit enter twice, then go to render, render animation, or control F12 on your keyboard. And this will render all the way through and it'll give you a nice 5 second animation at 60 frames per second. Then importing this into OBS is more or less identical to last week, but I'll go over it one more time very quickly. So if we hop over into OBS, we can bring up our little Windows Explorer right here. We can find our file. So overlay, heck yes. Oh, no, no, no. I want the still one. Just drag it into OBS. Now we have our overlay. Then you want to add a new source, which is a video capture device. And I'm currently using my camera to record this tutorial, so I'm just gonna grab a still of myself from last week under working the face ref. But this would be your camera source. You drag this into place. You're gonna want to scale it down to match whatever you did. Something like that's probably pretty cool. And then you're gonna want to align this with the overlay and crop it by holding Alt and dragging on the edges. And you're gonna wanna spend some time really aligning this. And one way to do that would be to right click it, go to Transform, Edit Transform, and then you can put your, you can click in one of the boxes for the cropping of left and right, and you can crop this by scrolling your mouse wheel, just going up one or two pixels at a time until you get it matching absolutely perfectly. And that pretty much sums it up. Now it looks like we're sort of popping out of our background image, which I think is pretty cool. One quick last thing before we go. You're also probably going to want to group these two things together. So you can select your video, camera, and your overlay. Right click and you can say group selected items. So then you can move the entire thing around together and scale it. Whoops. Hey. And then you can scale it as well to fit whatever your needs are. So with that being said, now we are actually done. Hopefully at this point, you have your green screen camera overlay with your personalized background. If you have any questions or just wanna come hang out, I'm live every Tuesday, Friday, and Saturday at twitch.tv/oraclefishlive. And if you found this video helpful, make sure you hit that like and subscribe button below the video for new content every single week. Let me know in the comments what you wanna learn next. And until next time, my name is Chris Folea. I'm your stream scholar, and class is out.